Hello, all you beautiful people, and welcome to another installment of State of the Union. I am your host and Chicago Union intern, Charlie Youssef, and this show is to bring you guys all things Ultimate Frisbee and Chicago Union. In this episode, I will be telling you guys my top four things to watch this season for the Chicago Union. If you missed the last couple episodes, be sure to check out the description below. In that, I will be putting the playlist with all the episodes there. You should check out the last episode where I had an awesome exclusive interview with head coach Dave Woods, so be sure not to miss that. Like I mentioned before, this episode is going to cover my top four things to watch for the Chicago Union in the 2023 season. Some of these things are milestone breakers, and other things are just changes in the roster in the organization that may have an effect on the upcoming season. So without further ado, let's get right into it. The first milestone I'll be tracking this season will be because of our lone All-Star last season, Ross Barker. He is on pace to break 200 goals this season, sitting at 151 currently. If Barker reaches 200 goals this season, that would make him only the 21st player all-time in the AUDL to reach the milestone, and only the second player all-time for the Chicago Union, the other being AJ Nelson, who holds the record currently with 203 goals. Reaching 200 goals in the AUDL is not easy for anybody. For Barker, who not only scores but also spends half his time assisting other players, this could be a little bit more of a challenge. Barker's all-time personal record for goals in a season is 49, so he must match that record in order to reach 200 goals this season, and if he wants to break AJ Nelson's record, he'd have to break his own record by 4 goals. We'll see how that goes, especially since a lot of the roster shakeup this offseason will definitely affect Ross Barker's role. Pavel Janis leaving the organization is the reason Ross Barker is probably going to have to take on a little bit of a different role this season. And that brings me to my next question. How will the Chicago Union look without star player Pavel Janis this season? Janis left the organization to join the Los Angeles Aviators, a team that ended up going 4-8 last season. Pavel Janis has not only been one of the most important players in Chicago Union history, but he's also been one of the most important players in AUDL history throughout the entirety of his career. Leading the team in scoring was just one of the many highlights Pavel Janis had last season. The most important highlight of Janis' season last year was becoming the all-time leader in assists in the AUDL. According to Coach Woods, whether or not the team would look different without Pavel Janis has been a question everybody's been asking all offseason.
Since he joined the team, he's been a presence. And one thing I always like to acknowledge is that more than just what you lose on the field with Pavel, he was a great leader also. He served as captain for several seasons, and he was a great leader. So that's something that we are also losing this year with losing Pavel. Fortunately, we do have strong captains this season with Jack Shanahan, Sam Kaminsky, and Jace Bruner. So they already are stepping into those roles to help fill that void. And then with Pavel, his stats speak for itself in that he was a large contributor to our offense. The way that we are approaching that is we know that we can't replace Pavel. We're not going to try to do that. So we are just going to have to adjust and use the strengths of the people that we do have on our O-line, use those strengths to the best of their ability and fit those pieces together to try to reestablish a high-powered offense that probably is going to look a little different and maybe for the better. Pavel was playing against the same teams for several seasons. So now teams are going to have to adjust to us not having that.
Obviously, without Janis, the offense is going to look different. But that's what the new and improved receiving core is all about. Another important question for the Chicago Union this season is whether or not the new and improved receiving core is going to hold up to the hype that everybody's been bringing to it. Ross Barker is not only close to reaching 200 goals, but he is also very close to reaching the all-time record for receiving yards in the AUDL. In order to break the receiving record, he needs to match his receiving totals from the last few years, which is about 3,400 yards. One of the few things standing in the way of Ross Barker breaking this all-time receiving yards record is his new teammate from the Detroit Mechanics, Andrew Sogren. Sogren sure got his show of looks in Detroit, reaching the top five in total receiving yards all-time in the AUDL while he's now currently only about 1,400 yards away from breaking the record and about 2,000 yards more than Ross Barker has. Four other athletes fill out the rest of the receiving corps, two of which being Sam Kaminsky and Jack Shanahan, who are two of our 2023 captains. The last two guys rounding out the receiving group include Paul Arters and Eli Artemakis. Last stat I wanted to watch this year has to do with the big man, Nate Goff. For a majority of the offseason, Nate Goff wasn't even on the roster. He was a late addition after the official roster had already been announced. Nate Goff has spent the last 3 years on the Chicago Union and signed a 3-year extension this offseason. Goff is also 10 blocks away from becoming the all-time leader in Chicago Union blocks. Last season, Goff led the team with 16 total blocks and has gotten up to 19 total blocks in his career. So reaching this milestone shouldn't be too hard for him. Hopefully by the end of this contract, Nate Goff can run away with the all-time record. We talked a lot about record breaking today, but the AUDL began tracking a new stat last season that needs some new record breakers. In AUDL terms, a huck is a 40-yard plus throw that ends in a completion. Now, I want to go back out onto Elmhurst University's campus and find out how many people actually huck. I'll be going out on the mall, measuring out 40 yards, and asking students to throw a frisbee as far as they can. Anybody that reaches 40 yards will receive a really sick prize from the Chicago Union. So let's head out to it.
Welcome back to Elmhurst University, folks. Last time I was on campus, I tested kids on their knowledge of ultimate frisbee. Today, I will be giving kids opportunities to check out their athleticism and throw a huck. If they can throw a frisbee over 40 yards in 3 throws, they can win a frisbee for themselves. Here we go. I'm here with my first contestant,
Elijah.
Elijah's going to try to throw the frisbee 40 plus yards in 3 tries. He's got to go concrete to concrete. Let's get it.
Go ahead. Let's see your first throw. Ooh, okay.
That was trash.
Go ahead, you got 2 more tries.
That was dang.
It just sucked another way.
Nice try, Elijah. Just for your efforts, I'll give you a wristband and a sticker.
W.
I'm here with my next contestant.
BP.
Boy.
Jalen.
My name is Yazer.
Divine Martinez.
Reagan.
Elijah's back for a second attempt. I thought I'd give him a little redemption here.
Pete Greedy.
All right, Pete, you get to walk home with the frisbee.
That's awesome.
Go Union. Go Union. I'm here with my next contestant.
Mitchell Westfall.
Josh Kubicki.
The cameraman.
I'm Sarah.
Eli Spence.
Noah Reed.
All right, I am here with my next contestant,
Sandro.
Sandro was able to throw it over the 40-yard mark twice. So, Sandro, you get a frisbee.
Let's go.